The videos. Turn on the videos, all of you. Everyone. Venkatesh. Six. Slide number six. Yes, very good morning, students. We have completed up to page number 39, I hope. Am I right? Up to page number 39, we have completed. Guys, once again, let us recollect the characters in the play, one act play. Total seven characters are there. In that, Jimmy has no words, no dialogues. Only six characters are active in this one act play. Once again, recollect the names of those characters. What is the grandpa's name? Any of you? Abel Merriweather. Abel Merriweather is a grandpa. And he has how many daughters? How many daughters? Two daughters. You can give lip movement. No problem. I can understand, students. So he has two daughters. The elder daughter's name is Amelia. What is her name? Amelia Slaughter. And the second daughter's name is Elizabeth Jordan. Elizabeth. So Amelia marries whom? Whom does she marry? Amelia? Henry Slaughter. So Amelia's husband's name is Henry Slaughter. Elizabeth marries Ben Jordan. So that's why Elizabeth Jordan. Elizabeth Jordan marries Ben Jordan. Okay. So Amelia and Slaughter, Henry Slaughter, they have one daughter. Her name is Victoria. Her age is 10 years. And Elizabeth and Ben Jordan, they have one son. His name is Jimmy. So total seven characters are here. But Jimmy will not come into the scene. Only six characters will play the role. Only Jimmy's name will be there. Okay, fine. So now where we are is here. Slaughter, Mrs. Slaughter, that Amelia, she is very much interested to bring that bureau in grandpa's room. Bureau is there, no? She has to. What is bureau? That writing desk. She has to bring that writing desk down. She has to. And just she will go up. In that grandpa's room, and she will clear the way or clear what are the things are there. Just she will clear that one because to bring that bureau. After that, there she finds one attractive clock, and she brings that clock down, and she tells that their clock is unworthy. That's why she brought that one, and she is very attractive, and she is very much interested to take that clock. And where does she place the clock? On the mantelpiece. That day I explained you what is mantelpiece. On that fireplace will be there, no? That rack will be there where they will put the fire. On that rack, she will keep that clock. Now let us move to that page number 40. Okay, see, Victoria. That's grandpa's clock. She says, that is grandpa's clock. It is not ours. Why did you bring this one? So this is grandpa's clock. Mrs. Slaughter, be quiet. It's ours now. Come. Henry, lift your hand. So she said immediately she controlled. Okay, she controlled her daughter and she said that be quiet. That is not grandpa's clock. That is ours now. That is our clock. And now she called her husband, Henry. Come, Henry, lift your hand. So just you let us carry this. What they are planning to carry, that furniture, the drawers were there, no? Just they want to carry the drawers up to the room and they have to place the drawers there, the furniture they have to keep there and they have to bring the bureau down from the upstairs. That's why she asked, is lift at your end. Henry and Mrs. Slaughter, very hot and flush, struggle in with a pretty old-fashioned bureau containing a locked desk. They put it where the chest of drawers was and straightened ornaments, etc. There is a knock at the door. The knocking is repeated. Now that is very heavy. Already he said that. Already Henry said that. That is not delicate. That is very difficult to bring down. That bureau is very heavy, very strong. So it is very difficult to lift. Like that he said. Henry already he suggested his wife, but she didn't listen. Now they are bringing that bureau down from the upstairs while bringing the heavy objects. Maybe you have experienced this one. While lifting the heavy objects, how you feel? Just you feel very hot. Our body, just suddenly it will become very hot and sweaty also and flushed, hot and flushed. They have become very hot. The body has become very hot for them. Stagger, S-T-A-G-G-E-R. Stagger means walking unsteady. So while lifting something, we can't balance. Heavy objects while lifting, we can't balance our body. At that time, what we will do? Will walk unsteadily. Now, these two are walking unsteadily because that is a very heavy object. That bureau is very heavy. That's why they are walking unsteadily in which a pretty old-fashioned bureau containing a locked desk. Locked desk is there for that bureau and they brought that one in. They put it where the chest of drawers was and straightened the ornaments, etc. There is a knock at the door. So they kept that one in place of that furniture, the drawers were there, no? In that place, they have placed that bureau. While placing that one, while arranging that one, while adjusting that one, at that time only, they heard the knock at the door. So what is that knocking sound? Have you heard the knocking sound? What is knocking sound? Just if you go to somebody's house, if the door is closed, at that time, what will you do? If there is no calling bell, what will you do? Just you will knock the door. Okay. So how you will knock the door? So politely you have to knock the door means these are called knuckles. Joints are there, no fingers. Joints are there, no. These are called knuckles. With the knuckles we have to. Okay. We have to make. We have to touch the door. That is called knocking sound. So they heard the knocking sound. They heard the knocking sound. The knocking is repeated. Repeatedly they are getting the knocking sound. Yes. Victoria shows in Ben and Mrs. Jordan. Now who entered? Ben and Jordan. Mrs. Jordan. That is Elizabeth Jordan and Ben Jordan. They entered. And Victoria, she opened the door. And this Elizabeth Jordan and Ben Jordan. Who is Elizabeth, ma? Who is Elizabeth? Amelia's sister. Amelia's sister. And Ben is? Who is Ben? Elizabeth's husband. These two entered now. Okay. The letter is a stout. Letter means second mention. Whom they have mentioned here? Second, who is mentioned here? Mrs. Jordan. Mrs. Jordan means Elizabeth Jordan. How she is? She is a stout. She is also fat. It seems stout. Complacent. Complacent means self-satisfied. Who will give much importance to themselves, to self. And she is a self-satisfied lady. Outfit as a woman with an irritating air of being always right. Okay. And how she is, means she thinks always she is right. Whatever she says, that is right. Okay. That kind of nature she has. She is wearing an outfit of new mourning. So even she is also wearing that new clothes, but which represents or which expresses her sorrow. That means she is also wearing black colored dress. Ben is also in complete new mourning. That even he is also wearing. That Ben Jordan, he is also wearing that black color suit only. He is rather a jolly little man, but at present trying to adapt himself to the regretful occasion. Actually, he is a joyful person. Always. As a just you know that the importance of class, you are not supposed to behave like that. Pay attention. Pay attention. Listen carefully. Don't do such kind of silly things. Then you will be left from the group. You will be left from the Zoom class. After that, you will not be alone. Be cautious. Be attentive in the class. Okay, fine. Let us continue. So now here, just he is a jolly person. Is always he'll be in cheerful mood, happy mood. But the occasion, how the occasion? Now what is the occasion? The death. So here he has to get adjusted to this sad or sorrowful situation. So he is trying to get adjusted to the occasion. Okay. So Mrs. Jordan sails into the room and solemnly goes straight to Mrs. Slato and kisses her. The men shake hands. So now that is quite common. You know that sister has gone to her elder sister. Elizabeth has gone to her elder sister, Amelia, and she hugs and kisses her. Yes, expressing her, what is that? Just I can say that her love towards her, or just consoling her. Maybe we can think like that. And after that, these two men, they shake hands. Who are they? These two men meets Amelia's husband. Who is Amelia's husband, ma? Who is Amelia's husband? Henry Slater. Henry Slater and Elizabeth's husband. What is Elizabeth's husband's name? Ben Jordan. These two men. Okay. These two men, they shake hands. Okay. Now, Mrs. Jordan, see what she's saying. Well, Amelia, and he has gone at last. See the sentence, how she is telling. At last, he has gone. Yes. Chivarga, atan velli poyadu. So, he has gone at last. Finally, he has gone. Finally, he died. Like that, she said. Mrs. Slater, yes, he has gone. Aun, atan velli poyadu. He was 72 a fortnight last Sunday. She sniffs back at you. And she said that 15 days back only, he came into 72 years. 72 has fallen. Okay, 15 days before. So 15 days before, I think 72 years. Now they are just telling, that age also. Here they are mentioning the age of their father. And she is telling that he got 72 years, 15 days back. And she sniffs back at you. Sniffs. Sniffs means taking the air back into the nose. So when will you do that one? When you are crying at the time, you will do that one. Like that. No? To take back the tears. When the tears are falling at that time, we will sniff back. Sniff. That means taking the air back or take the tears back. Okay. Now, Bensie. Now, Amelia, you must not give way. We have all got to die someday, sometime or other. So now he is also, Ben Jordan, he is trying to console his sister-in-law, is Amelia. He is telling, Amelia, don't worry. So even we have to die one day. Okay, so this is a routine dialogue. This is a common dialogue. Wherever you attend the death ceremony at that time, people will be using this dialogue. Yes, maybe you heard this one. Andaru akros chanipovalsina vallame. Ayana ellipoyaru manam kuda akros chanipotham. So you don't cry. So ippudu edvalsina avasaram em ledu. Even we have to die one day. That is must. Compulsory we are going to die. So no need to worry about that one. Yes, Mrs. Jordan now. And now perhaps you will tell us all about it. Now she said that how it had happened. Ella chanipoyaru. Just you have to give the information. You have to give the details to us. Yes, they asked because they were not there when father died. That's why they are inquiring. That Elizabeth, she is inquiring her sister about that information about her. She is asking information regarding her father's death. Yes, father had been married. See what she is telling. Father, today morning he was very happy. He was very happy. And today morning after having his breakfast, after completing his breakfast, he went to pay insurance. You know that insurance, life insurance policies people will take. So he went today morning only after having his breakfast, he went to pay that insurance. To pay that insurance, he went. Like that she said. My word. It's a good thing he did. See, immediately see the dialogue. He changed. Good thing he has paid the insurance. So he has paid the premium. So monthly, quarterly policies. So here he said, good thing he has paid. Ammaya manchidi. Atanu pages sada. Insurance amount pages chanipoyada. So see the mentality of the people. Okay. And see now Mrs. Jordan, see. He always was thoughtful in that way. He was too honorable to have gone without paying his premium. And immediately she started apprising praising her father. So who is that? Mrs. Jordan, Elizabeth. So she started praising. He is very thoughtful. My father is very thoughtful. Thoughtful means cautious. He is very alert. He knows when the work should be done. He knows very well. And immediately he will finish that work. That's why he has completed the task. And after that, he has gone. So, ma nanagaru chala alert, chala telivaina varu. Eppudu ye pani cheyalo correct ga chestaru. So, that's why he has completed his task. Like that, he has praised Henry. And when I came in, I found him undressed, sure enough, and snug in bed. So, Henry, he said that. Who is Henry? Amelia's husband, elder daughter's husband. He said that, when I came in, I found him undressed. Undressed means here you have to just understand that he is wearing nightdress. So he is in nightdress and snug in bed. So he was warm in bed. He was lying on the bed. He is Mrs. Slater. And when we had finished dinner, I thought I would take up a bit of something on tray. He was lying there for all the world as if he was asleep. So I put the tray down on the bureau, on the chest of drawers, and went to waken him. He was quite cold. I immediately, what he said, yesterday after completing our dinner, means nighttime. Okay. So after completing the dinner, I thought to give something, to offer something to him. That's why I put something, eatables, in the tray. And I went up to his room. When I went there, he was lying on his bed. And just I kept that tray where I have kept that. I kept the tray on the bureau. By mistake, she used the word bureau. Actually, is a bureau or room lo unnattu vallaku teliyagoddu. But all of a sudden, just she used the word bureau. I kept that on the bureau. I kept the tray on the bureau. She used. Again, she has corrected herself. Okay, not bureau. I kept it on that chest of drawers. That a table was there. No, there I have kept that one. And just I observed, he was quite cold. You know that after the death, the dead body will become cool, very cool. It becomes cool. So I touched him. He has become very cool. He's a pass. They wipe their eyes and sniff back tears. Immediately they wipe their tears. Okay, the tears will be falling. Just they wipe their tears. And once again, they sniff back tears. Once again, they have sniffed, taking the air in. Okay, they sniff back the tears. Okay, next. Mrs. Slater, rising briskly at length. In a business-like tone, he changed his tone immediately. That Mrs. Slater, well, will you go up and look at him now? Or shall we have tea? See the situation. Already dead body is there in the house. That too, that daughter has entered. And if you hear the news, such kind of news, means what will you do? If you go to some death, at that time, what will you do? Immediately, you will go and see the dead body first. After that, only the remaining, all the things. Just we will speak to others. But see here, how much time got over? She came, she got settled down. After that, they are speaking all these things. But these people, they didn't go to see the dead body only. Okay, they are still down only. They didn't go upstairs. Still they are down only. And now she offered, this Amelia offered, shall we have tea? So will you take some tea or will you go up? Ippude velli nanagarini chustara lekapothe tea tagesi malli velthara, like that. She asked. She offered tea. Mrs. Jordan, what do you say, Ben? Immediately Jordan, that Elizabeth, she asked her husband. What will you say? Mire antaru velli choose vastama lekapothe tea tagesi veldama, like that she asked. Ben, I'm not particular. So she said that whatever it may be, no problem either tea or just if you are willing to go upstairs adaina parled ide
madam start jen.
Okay, Mahendra, next slide. Mahendra, next slide. Okay, so he said that I'm not particular. Yes, whatever it may be, if you are willing to go upstairs, okay. Otherwise, if you want to drink tea also, I'm ready, like that he said. Yes, next, Mrs. Jordan, is serving the table. Well, then if the kettle is ready, we may ask, well, have tea first. So just they prefer tea first. Decide if the kettle is ready. Kettle, you know, where they will put the tea or just boil the tea. Kettle, you know very well. So where they will boil the tea. So if the kettle is ready, first we will drink tea. After that, we will go and see the dead body like that. See, ఎంత అన్యాయం చూడండి. సో ఫస్ట్ టీ తాగేసి మళ్ళీ డెడ్ బాడీని చూస్తాము. కెటల్ గన్ రెడీగా ఉంటే గనక టీ చేసేసేయండి. టీ తాగేసి మళ్ళీ డెడ్ బాడీని చూస్తాము అంటున్నారట. ఓకే, సో మిసెస్ స్లాటర్ పుట్స్ ద కెటల్ ఆన్ ద ఫైర్ అండ్ గెట్స్ టీ రెడీ. సో ఆన్ ద ఫైర్ షీ పుట్ ద కెటల్. కెటల్ ని ఫైర్ మీద పెట్టి జస్ట్ షీ ఈస్ హీటింగ్ దట్ టీ. హెన్రీ, వన్ థింగ్ వి మే యాస్ వెల్ డిసైడ్ నౌ ఇన్ ద అనౌన్స్మెంట్ ఇన్ ద పేపర్స్. Now Henry, he said that one thing, just we may as well decide. We have to decide one thing. What is that? We have to give the announcement of this death news in the newspaper. Just we have to announce in the newspaper. Like that, he said. I was thinking of that. What would you put? So Mrs. Jordan also, she asked. Elizabeth also, she said that, okay, what we have to put in the newspaper? And what is the matter we have to put in the newspaper? Like that, she said. Is that's a small pass. Is Mrs. Jordan, well, we will think about tea after tea, and then we will look through his bits of things and make a list of them. There is all the furniture in his room. So here Mrs. Jordan, he said, okay, first we will drink tea. We'll drink tea. After that, we will discuss all those things, and even the bits of things are there. So his bits of things means the things which are belong to him, the property or whatever it may be. All those things are there. We have to prepare a list of them. Why they want to prepare that list? Do you have any idea why they want to prepare the list? Enduku list prepare cheyalanukuntunnaru vallu? Because they want to divide. Vanni divide cheskovali kada, iddaru panchukovali kada. Okay, that's why they decided to put that, prepare the list of those things which are belong to Abel. Okay, next. There is no jewelry or valuables of that sort. Immediately Henry said that there is no jewelry. Jewelry, you know, nagalu. Nagalu em levu. Okay, nagalu em levu. Or valuables of that sort. అంత విలువైన అయితే ఏం లేవు. సో జ్యువెలరీ లేదు. నెక్స్ట్, ద వాల్యుబుల్స్ ఆఫ్ దట్ సార్ట్ ఆర్ నాట్ దేర్. అంత విలువైన వస్తువులు ఏం లేవు. ఓకే, మిస్సెస్ జార్డన్, ఎక్సెప్ట్ హిస్ గోల్డ్ వాచ్ హి ప్రామిస్ దట్ టు అవర్ జిమ్మీ. సో ఇమీడియట్లీ షీ సెడ్ దట్ yes, except one thing you said, this his gold watch is there. No, he said. Immediately she inquired, gold watch is there, his gold watch is there, but already he promised that to our Jimmy. Ma appai kisanane already promised chesa nana garu. So that gold watch undal kada, adi undi kada, gold watch okati unnattu undi. I never heard of that. Me Jimmy promised chesara. So when did he promise that one? I never heard of that. Mem eppudu vinlede. Immediately she said that me appai kisan annara gold watch. I didn't hear that one. Mem eppudu alante em vinlede. Like this, yeah. Mrs. Jordan, oh, but he did, Amelia, when he was living with us, was very fond of Jimmy. So immediately she said that yes, Jimmy, yes, he promised that watch to Jimmy when he was staying with us. Nanagar maato unnappudu promise chesaru that he is very fond of Jimmy. జిమ్మీ అంటే అతనికి చాలా ఇష్టము, మనవడు అంటే అతనికి చాలా ఇష్టము. దట్స్ వై హీ ప్రామిస్ దట్ గోల్డ్ వాచ్ టు జిమ్మీ. మిసెస్ స్లాటర్, ఎస్ ఓకే, వెల్ ఐ డోంట్ నో. షీ సెడ్ దట్ అమెలియా, షీ సెడ్ దట్ రియలీ నిజమా, ఐ డోంట్ నో దట్ వన్. ఇవ్వడం ఇష్టం లేదు. ఓకే, సో ఆ గోల్డ్ వాచ్ ని వదులుకోవడం ఇష్టం లేదు. దట్స్ వై షీ సెడ్ ఓకే, ఓకే, ఐ డోంట్ నో, నాకైతే తెలియదు. లైక్ దట్ షీ సెడ్. బెన్, ఎనీహో, there is his insurance money. Have you got the receipt for the premium he paid this morning? Immediately Ben said, okay, insurance money is also there. So you are telling that morning only he has paid that insurance. So even that insurance money is also there. No, so we have to discuss about that money also. I have not seen it. So Mrs. Slater, that Amelia, she said that I didn't see the slip morning. The premium you are telling that he has paid, but the slip is not there. The receipt is not there with us. Victoria jumps up from the sofa and comes behind the table. That girl is playing there, jumping from the sofa, and there she jumps from the sofa and she comes near the table. Victoria, what she says? Mother, I don't think Grandpa went to pay his insurance this morning. And she said that, I don't think that Grandpa has paid that insurance today morning. You are thinking that morning he went to pay that premium of that insurance. But that is wrong. I don't think that he has paid the insurance. Yes. Mrs. Slater, he went out. But he went out, Victoria. Morning, why killar Tatagaru? Like that she said. Victoria, yes. But he didn't go into the town. He met old Mr. Tattersall down the street and they went off past St. Philip's Church. She said that he didn't go to town. Town killaledu, Tatagaru putuna. I observed. Then where did he go? He met old Mr. Tatter down the street. Mr. Tattersall ni meet ayyaru Tatagaru. Mr. Tattersall ni ekkada meet ayyaru at the end of the street. He met him and they went off past St. Philip's Church. Vallidder kalisi St. Philip's Church ki vellaru. Both of them, they went to church. But he didn't go to town. Town ki velaledu to pay the premium. Do you think he hasn't paid it? Was it overdue? Immediately Ben. Who is Ben? Elizabeth's husband. So immediately he entered into the scene and he said that. So he didn't pay that amount morning. So overdue is there. Overdue unda. So in time pay cheyakapothe, either it is loan or whatever the premium or whatever it may be, it is called overdue amount, you know well. So overdue unda, overdue amount is there, like that he asked. Yes, Mrs. Slater, I should think it was overdue, maybe. Overdue unnatundi, overdue amount. We have to pay that overdue amount. Mrs. Jordan, something tells me he has not paid it. Even I feel that he hasn't paid. So nenu anukuntunanu intaku mundu what they said, the same mouth, same people, what they said. A father is thoughtful, ma nana garu chala thoughtful, he is very active, he is very alert. So in time lo e pan cheyala in time lo chesaru, like that they priced inta varaku aa insurance amount pay chesaru ani telisina ventane they priced him. But now what they are telling, see, ankodam ledu atanu pay chestaru ani anukonu, like that they are telling. See Ben, how he is called the drunken old beggar. So how he started scolding the person, see. So immediately tagu both beggar, tagu both adukune vadu, and it's like that. Just he has scolded his father-in-law. Val mamu garni ela tittunnaru chudandi, because he didn't pay the money and he died. Pay cheyakundane chanipoyarani, just he said that the drunken old beggar, he is a drunken old beggar, like that he has scolded him. Okay Mahendra, next slide. Next slide, Mahendra. Yes. See page number 42. Mrs. Jordan, he has done it on purpose, just to annoy us. So now immediately the dialogues got changed. Okay, so what is till now the people, the priced with the same mouth, they started scolding him. ఎవరైతే ఏ నోరుతో అయితే ప్రైస్ చేశారో పొగిడారో అదే నోరుతో ఇప్పుడు తిట్టడం స్టార్ట్ చేశారు. సో వాట్ దే ఆర్ టెలింగ్ సి హి హాస్ డన్ ఇట్ ఆన్ పర్పస్ వాంటెడ్లీ హి హాస్ డన్ ఆల్ దిస్ థింగ్స్ జస్ట్ టు అనాయ్ us, దట్ మీన్స్ ఓన్లీ టు ఇరిటేట్ us, టు టార్చర్ us, హి హాస్ డన్ ఆల్ దిస్ థింగ్స్ కావాలనే ఇది చేశాడు, కావాలనే కట్టకుండా చచ్చిపోయాడు, మనల్ని టార్చర్ చేయడానికి ఇలా చేశాడు. సో మిసెస్ స్లాటర్, ఆఫ్టర్ ఆల్ ఐ హావ్ డన్ ఫర్ హిమ్ having to put up with him in the house these 3 years, it's nothing short of swindling. So immediately this Slater is Amelia Slater, she started, for these 3 years we are burying him, so everything we have given, we allowed him to stay with us, ee 3 samvatsaralu maato undanichamu, atani kavalsinavanni chusukunamu, but at last he tried to cheat us. Swindling is nothing but trying to cheat. So he tried to cheat us. So Jordan, I have to put up with him for 5 years. Immediately she said that for these 3 years, just only for 3 years he is staying with you. But 5 years he stayed with us. Maato aidellu naru, ito mudelle unindi. But maato aithe aidu samacharalga unnaru, aidu samacharalu unnaru. So Mrs. Slater, and you are trying to turn him over to us all the time. ఉన్నారులే 5 సంవత్సరాలు ఉన్నారు అంటున్నావు కదా, ఎప్పుడు చూసినా మా దగ్గర పంపించేయాలని ట్రై చేస్తున్నావు. ఆల్వేస్ యు ఆర్ ట్రైంగ్ టు సెండ్ హిమ్ టు అవర్ హౌస్. సో ఫర్ నేమ్ సేక్ 5 ఇయర్స్ హీ వాస్ దేర్, బట్ ఆల్వేస్ యు ఆర్ టార్చరింగ్ హిమ్ ఆర్ యు ఆర్ ట్రైంగ్ టు సెండ్ హిమ్ టు అస్. ఓకే, బట్ వీ డోంట్ నో ఫర్ సర్టెన్ దట్ హీ హాస్ నాట్ పేడ్ ద ప్రీమియం. సో ఇమీడియట్లీ హెన్రీ ఎంటర్డ్ ఇన్ ద సీన్ అండ్ హీ సెడ్ దట్ సో హీ హాస్ డైవర్టెడ్ ద టాపిక, అదర్వైజ్ these two sisters may quarrel. Okay, so that's why immediately Henry has entered and he said that. So we don't know why he didn't pay that premium. What is the reason? What is the correct reason? Why didn't he pay the premium like that he is telling? So Mrs. Slater, Victoria, run upstairs and fetch that bunch of keys that is on your grandpa's dressing table. So immediately this Slater, Amelia Slater, she said, she instructed her daughter Victoria, and she called Victoria and she said that go to your grandpa's room upstairs, and bunch of keys are there on his table. Just you bring that bunch of keys, bring immediately that bunch of keys. Is Victoria timidly in grandpa's room? So slowly she asked, in grandpa's room, like that. You know very well, if someone is dead, the children will be scared to enter into that room and they'll be scared of dead bodies. So Victoria, she said that to grandpa's room I have to enter, like that she asked. Yes, she said that. Mother said, yes, you have to enter. You have to go to grandpa's room. I don't like to. I can't go there, like that she said. Yes, Mrs. Slater, don't talk so silly, there is no one who can hurt you. Victoria goes out reluctantly. We will see if he has locked the receipt up in the bureau. So immediately that Slater says, just okay, no one is there. Don't talk so silly. Don't talk like a fool. Don't talk like a stupid. Just you go there. No one is there to hurt you. No one is alive to hurt you there. Go and get that keys. So let us check in the bureau. Now bureau is there down. Okay. So keys are there in upstairs and bureau is there down. So let us open the bureau and check whether he has kept the receipt inside the bureau, like that she said. And now Victoria goes there without interest only. She will go there. Okay. Students, I'll send you a few questions in the group. Just you write down the answers for that. After that, just post the answers in the group. Understood? I'm going to send some questions related to this lesson as worksheet. Just you complete that one, write the answers for that, read the lesson and write the answers and post in the WhatsApp group. I'll check the answers. Understood? Is it clear? Is it clear, students? I'm going to send some questions related to this lesson in the WhatsApp group. Okay, your group is there, no? 10th standard group. In that I'll post it. Just you write down the answers and post in your group only. I'll check your answers. Okay. Yes, Mahendra. Unmute. Mahendra, unmute all the students.